I've been running my original Prusa i3 Mark II now for about 2000 hours, and a couple of weeks ago the first major issue was happening. A part of the PEI sheet ripped out when I tried to remove a print which was stuck quite well to the build platform. In this video I'll be showing you how you can quick fix it, which doesn't require changing the whole PEI sheet. Guten Tag everybody, I'm Stefan and welcome to CNC Kitchen. I feared that this would happen sometime, but to be honest, it took quite a while until the PEI sheet finally failed on me. This happened while I was removing a print with a spatula and resulted in a patch of PEI being stuck to the back of a part. Luckily, I was able to remove it in one piece, which still fit well into the hole it left. The failure happened right in the middle of the bed, where most of the parts are printed, and therefore the print surface is stressed the most and finally failed due to fatigue. I thought at first that it was finally time to change the PEI sheet, which can be purchased as a spare part. Unfortunately, the process of replacing it is pretty complicated because you have to remove the bed, freeze it, remove the PEI, soak the glue in limonene several times and then try to scrape off the glue. If you succeed in getting your bed clean, then there is also some skill required to add the new sheet square and without bubbles. Limonene is also quite expensive, so you see that this seems to be a lot of effort. I'm really looking forward to getting my hands on one of the spring steel powder coated print beds of the Mark III, because this solution seems to be really robust, and if it failed, you don't need to mess around with solvents and just buy a new one. Well, so since my bed was only damaged in a small region, I thought about how I might be able to avoid replacing the whole PEI. The residues of the sheet still fit perfectly into the hole, but they would be ripped out when I print the next time on them. If you're not new to 3D printing, you will remember that we used to use Kapton tape on print beds to have our parts stuck to it. Kapton, which is actually a brand name, is a very high resistant polymer film, which is also commonly used in electronics for isolation. It usually comes as an adhesive tape and is very thin and strong. So I cleaned the area of the rip with isopropanol and just taped a small piece of Kapton tape over it. It should be a good part bigger than the failed area to make it strong enough. If you want to buy some Kapton tape, don't go for the cheapest one because they're usually fake. This material is expensive, but a small roll will not ruin you. In order to increase the stickivity for the prints even more, I lightly sanded the area with fine sandpaper, cleaned everything and gave it a try. It actually works very well and does not influence the printing process. I've been using it for several weeks now and did not have to replace it so far. It will leave a small scar on your prints, but that should usually be bearable. It's a quick fix, but it works very well for me, so maybe give it a try before you start your big PEI replacement adventure.
After many of you have already been asking, I finally created a Patreon page where you can support my work and help me out a little bit. I'm very thankful for every dollar you can spare, so please check it out. Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and please subscribe if you haven't. Thanks for watching, auf Wiedersehen, and I will see you next time.